going to study about an interesting topic in mathematics, namely arithmetic progression. So today we are going to study about arithmetic progression. For this, first we consider a given list of numbers. Here I consider the list of numbers such as 5, 10, 15, 20, etc. Here, which is the first number in this list? First number is 5. Which is the second number? Second number is 10. Which is the third number? Third number is 15. And the fourth number is 20. So here I use the word number to represent the first one. Second one is represented as second number. So in this list, each of the numbers in the list is called a term. That means each number is replaced by the term, each term. That means first number is replaced by, first number is replaced by first term. That means here the first term is 5 and the second term is 10 and the third term is 15 and the fourth term is 20. First, here we have a list of numbers. First number is 5, second one 10, third one 15 and fourth one 20. So each of the numbers in this list is called a term. So we can replace first number by first term, second number by second term, etc. Then, is there any relationship between the numbers in this list? Here, which is the first term? 5. Which is the second term here? Second term is equal to 10. This 10 has any relationship between the first number? 10 can be written as, here, which is the first number? First term is 5. So, 10 can be written as first term plus 5. That means 5 plus 5 equal to 10. Then, how can we write the third term? Third term is equal to, here which is the third term? Third term is 15, is equal to second term plus 5. Here which is the second term? 10 plus 5 is equal to 15. Then, the fourth term can be written as, fourth term is equal to 20, which is equal to third term plus 5. We can find any relationship between these numbers. That means in this list of numbers, successive terms are obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding term. That means 10 is obtained by adding 5 to the first term. That means 5 plus 5 is equal to 10. Then 10 plus 5 is equal to 15 and 15 plus 5 is equal to 20. Then what is the next term here? 20 plus 5 is equal to 25. And similarly, you can find more terms to the list. That means we define an arithmetic progression by an arithmetic progression is a list of numbers. An arithmetic progression is a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding term. Fixed number to the preceding term. This is a condition except the first one. Except the first one. Here, look at this example. Second term can be obtained by 5 plus 5 is equal to 10. And third term can be obtained by 10 plus 5 is equal to 50. And fourth term can be obtained by 15 plus 5 is equal to 20. here, which is the fixed term in this list of numbers. Fixed term here, the fixed. Here the fixed number is equal to 5. This fixed number can be written as the common difference. The fixed number is called the fixed number is called the common difference. Fixed number is called the common difference. By the letter small letter D, we denote the common difference using the letter D. So, what is the definition of an arithmetic progression? An arithmetic progression is a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding term, except the first term. The fixed number is called the common difference of an AP. Okay, you just look at another example. Consider another list of numbers. 3, 3, 3, etc. This is the list of numbers. Here, which is the first term? First term is equal to 3. We can represent the first term by A1 and second term by A2, third term by A3, etc. up to nth term by AN. So, we can write the first term as A1 is equal to 3, which is the second term. A2 is equal to 3. A3 is equal to 3, etc. We have to check this is an AP or not. Arithmetic progression can be written as AP. We have to check this is an AP. If AP, what is the definition of an AP? A list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number. Here, 3, first term is 3 and second term is 3. So you can add 3 plus 0 get 3. Then 3 plus 0 get 3. So here the fixed number. Which is the fixed number here? Fixed number is 3. How can we represent the fixed number of an AP? Fixed number is denoted as common difference. D is equal to 3. That means you can find the common difference by finding the difference between two consecutive numbers. First, A2 minus A1 is equal to, what is the value of A2? 3 minus, which is the value of A1? 3, which is equal to 0. Then, you can find the difference between these consecutive numbers. That means A3 minus A2 is equal to 3 minus 3, which is equal to 0. Similarly, you can find the difference between any two consecutive numbers. Therefore, we can say that this list of numbers is an AP with first term. We can represent the first term. First term using letter A. First term A is equal to 3 and common difference. How can we represent the common difference? Common difference can be represented using the letter D, which is equal to. Here, what is the common difference? 0. So, we can say that this is an AP with the first term A is equal to 3 and common difference D is equal to 0. Look at another example, -3, -2, -1, 0, etc. We have to check this is an AP or not. Here, which is the first term? A1 is equal to -3, A2 is equal to -2, A3 is equal to -1, A4 is equal to 0. here. We have to find the difference between two consecutive numbers. So you first consider A2 minus A1. Put the value of A2 and A1 here. A2 is minus 2 minus, what is the value of A1? Minus 3, which is equal to minus 2. Minus and minus get plus. Plus 3, which is equal to minus 2 plus 3 is 1. Then you have to find the difference between next two consecutive tens. That means A3 minus A2, which is equal to, put the value of A3 and A2 here. A3 is minus 1 minus, put the value of A2. A2 is minus 2, which is equal to minus 1. Here is a minus and minus 2. The minus gets plus 2. What is minus 1 plus 2? Minus 1 plus 2 is 1. Therefore, similarly, you can find the difference between A4 and A3. That means A4 minus A3 is equal to, what is the value of A4 here? 0 minus, put the value of A3. A3 is minus 1, which is equal to 0. Minus and minus get plus 1, which is equal to 1. That means the difference between any two consecutive tens are same here. Here which is the same number 1. Therefore, we can say that 1 is the common difference. Here, the common difference is, common difference is equal to 1. It is the first term here, the first term A is equal to minus 3. Therefore, we can say that this is an AP. This is an AP. This is an AP with the first term A is equal to minus 3 and common difference D is equal to 1. Now we have to solve a problem. Find the AP. We given the value of A is equal to 6 and B is equal to 3. A is equal to 6 and B is equal to 3. That means first term is 6 and the second term is 3. And how can we write the form of our AP? AP is A, first term A, then A plus B. That means first term A, when you can add the common difference with the first term A plus B, A plus 2D. That means you can put the value of A and D here, A plus 3D, etc. This is the general form of an AP. General This is the general form of an AP with the A first term and D common difference. So you can put the value of A and D here. A means 6, A plus D. Put the value of A and D here. A is 6 plus. What is the value of D here? D is 3, next term is A plus 2D. Put the value of A, 6 plus 2 into, put the value of D here, 3, 6 plus 3 into 3, etc. Which implies, first term is 6, what is 6 plus 3? 6 plus 3 is 9. Then what is the next term? 6 plus 3 into 2, 6, 6 plus 3 into 3 is 9, which implies 6, 9. What is 6 plus 6? 6 plus 6 is 12, what is 9 plus 6? What is 9 plus 6? 15, etc. So, look at these numbers. First term 6, 6 plus 3 is 9, 9 plus 3 is 12, 12 plus 3 is 15, etc. Therefore, we get the arithmetic progression with the first 10 A is equal to 6 and the common difference D is equal to 3. The next question. Next question.
Six.
to check a given list of numbers is an AP or not. First you write the given list, given terms A1, A2, etc. up to n value. Then find the difference between two consecutive terms, that means A2 minus A1, A3 minus A2 and A4 minus A3. If the difference between these numbers are equal, then the given list of numbers is an AP. Okay, I hope all of you understand this concept. We will see you in next class. Thank you.